The reasoning, according to Health Secretary Sajid Javid, is that while cases are rising, two doses of vaccine provide effective protection against hospitalization, meaning that the healthcare system is unlikely to be overwhelmed, even if case numbers increase. And case numbers have been increasing, with the UK reporting over 30,000 daily cases recently. Load error experts contacted by Global News are divided, though, as to what lessons Canada should take from the UK's policy. "It's a tragic mistake," said Dr. Peter Juni, a professor of medicine and epidemiology at the University of Toronto and scientific director of Ontario's COVID-19 science advisory table. He believes that the UK will become a cautionary tale as the link between case numbers and hospitalisation still very much exists. "It is absolutely true that relative to the number of cases, the number of people admitted to the ICU and the number of people admitted to hospitals is lower," he said, "but the cases are on the rise in an exponential fashion and so are ICU and hospital occupancy. If the UK continues on the trajectory they currently are and if they open up more, it will actually get worse. It's a matter of time before ICUs in the UK are full again," Juni says, and he suspects this will happen by mid-September if the country continues on its current course. Movie theatres brace for a shortened summer season. Endangered turtles are getting struck and killed by cars, says conservation group. Will vaccine mixing take Canada into a two-shot summer? Ontario Premier Ford says students won't return to in-class learning until fall. Ford defends decision to keep schools closed until fall. Toronto's top doctor says return to in-person learning in fall should be done seamlessly. Ontario's top doctor formally announces his retirement, names replacement coronavirus. Ontario pledges $1.6 billion for municipalities, including funding for transit as Ontario gains control of third COVID-19 wave. Should in-person learning resume? Ford government approves splash pads during stay-at-home order. Fatal overdoses increased during pandemic. Report finds how mRNA vaccine technology could help fight other diseases. Working from home in the era of COVID-19, 75% of Canadians will get first shot of COVID-19 vaccine this summer. Trudeau parking in Kingston to go digital drive. Matthew Miller, an associate professor at the Michael G. de Groot Institute for Infectious Disease Research at McMaster University, disagrees. "The fact that we're seeing this pretty considerable spike in cases in the UK that has really, for the first time in the pandemic, become disconnected from numbers of deaths is a great sign," he said. "It should be really encouraging evidence that supports how well vaccines are working. Nevertheless, we should also look to the UK and understand that this massive spike in cases is largely driven by unvaccinated fragments of the population. And it should warn us how easily this virus can continue to spread, especially to those who haven't yet received the vaccine or who are not fully vaccinated. How Edmonton is attracting young talent to boost its economy. Britain will lift most COVID-19 restrictions July 19th. Johnson confirms wildfire burns near Saskatchewan's Highway 155. Focus on vaccines for the vulnerable, not booster shots for a few, says WHO. English soccer players subject to racist online abuse. South African army moves to stop violence after Zuma jailing. Italy's Euro Cup win leaves England fans heartbroken. Haiti in turmoil after president's assassination. Richard Branson rockets to space on his own ship. The debate over renaming Dundas Street. What to know about adapting to rising COVID-19 vaccinations. Fewer restrictions. Vaccination rates fall in US as case numbers rise. The efforts to reach unvaccinated Canadians. What is the impact of Richard Branson's space flight? Millions facing extreme heat. Wildfire risk in western US. Hundreds of wildfires fuel anxiety among BC residents. Ashley Tuite, an epidemiologist at the Dalai Lama School of Public Health at the University of Toronto, believes that we are seeing a disconnect between case counts and severe outcomes in the UK, but not a strong enough one to justify cutting all restrictions. You're seeing the effect of the vaccines in the sense that link between cases and hospitalizations and severe illness is weakened, but it's not broken, she said. You've seen this exponential increase in cases and then a few weeks later they started to see this exponential increase in people being admitted to hospital. And even if the risk of being hospitalized is lower if you're vaccinated, if you have enough people getting infected, you're still going to eventually overwhelm your healthcare system. While much of the UK was vaccinated with the AstraZeneca vaccine, Tuite doesn't think that will have had much of an impact on hospitalization numbers versus mRNA vaccines, as both have been shown to vastly reduce the chances of severe illness, she said. Miller thinks that an approach that relies on ICU numbers rather than case counts for removing or reimposing restrictions is prudent, but in order for it to work, we need to vaccinate as many people as possible. Even if we were to decide that not overwhelming ICUs was the sole goal of our COVID-19 restrictions, Tuite warned there might still be consequences for vulnerable populations. Even if societally we're not in a situation where we're worried about our healthcare system collapsing, if we're having thousands of infections happening in children and we start seeing kids end up in hospital hospital or children dying, then even if those numbers aren't large enough to overwhelm our healthcare system, are we okay with even a handful of additional deaths in children? She asked. Juni doesn't think Canada should follow the UK's lead when it comes to reopening, but instead cautiously remove restrictions and carefully monitor the outcomes. Ontario is probably the only region, Western region, in the world that has a really high percentage of the Delta variant and still is okay, and it's not, again, in exponential growth. If we have the next step of our reopening happening now, we will only start to see roughly 3 weeks after that what starts to happen with case counts. And then we can continue to calibrate our measures carefully so that we continue to successfully harvest the fruits of our vaccine rollout. It's so complicated, said Tuite. Because it's hard to guess the right answer, you have to prepare for every possibility, she said. I think at this point, it's a lot harder to backtrack than it is to take things slowly.